Hi, this is Xiaoxia Gao from the Nanotechnology User Facility at University of Washington. Today, we are going to operate the transmission electron microscope. The model is FEI Tech9 F20.
In a transmission electron microscope, an electron beam from the electron gun passes through an electromagnetic condenser lens through the sample, through an objective lens, and then down to a phosphor screen or CCD camera. The condenser lens controls the size and intensity of the beam hitting the sample. The objective lens controls the magnification. TEM images show internal structures of specimens with magnification up to 1 million times, revealing structures in atomic resolution. The first step is to prepare the sample and mount it in the holder. Remove the cover tube from the single tilt holder. Insert the tool into the hole and gently lift the clamp. Place tissue paper beneath in case the sample falls off. This sample has gold nanoparticles on a copper grid. Place the side with the particles facing down inside the specimen carrier. Gently lower the clamp. Replace the cover tube. Carry the sample with a hand over the end so that the arm can't slide out. Place the copper cold fingers slowly into a dewar of liquid nitrogen. Top off the dewar with additional liquid nitrogen. This will keep the sample cold. The TEM uses four pieces of software, which should be opened in order. Open Tech9 User Interface software, and you will hear a click-click, which confirms that the microscope is communicating with the computer. On the second monitor, we see the digital micrograph software. The third software is TIA, TEM Imaging and Analysis, which is used for recording scanning TEM and EDS. The last software is the RTEM control. Select Setup, Vacuum, and Turbo On, and hear the vacuum pump sound. After 3 minutes, the Turbo On box changes to yellow. In the user interface software, the box on the lower left tells the magnification and the microscope mode, currently TEM bright field and 175,000 magnification. To the right, the beam energy and spot size are shown. While setting up, the spot size will be 5, and during operation it will be 3. The exposure time tells you the brightness and illumination of the beam. The lower left box with L1, L2, L3 reflect the left control panel, and the R1, R2, and R3 shows the state of the right control panel. The multifunction controls are used for several functions in different modes. In the right bottom box, select Vacuum Overview to show the status of the vacuum system and valves. Now the Turbo On button is yellow, indicating the turbo pump has reached its full function and the TEM is ready to receive the sample. Take the holder out of the support. Place the little pin on the holder in the 5 o'clock position with a twist adjustment. The light goes on, the valves are opened, and the pump evacuates the sample chamber. You must wait for several minutes until the light goes off, or you could crash the vacuum. You must also tell the computer that it is a single tilt holder so that the holder can be controlled with a joystick. When the light goes out and the airlock status changes to column valves, the sample chamber has been evacuated. Now turn the holder counterclockwise and hold it as the vacuum sucks the holder slowly in. Now turn off the turbo pump. After the holder has been inserted, the vacuum in column should read 6, and you can start to adjust the beam. Click the column valves closed, and the button changes from yellow to gray, and the status reads ready. Take the cover off the phosphor screen. If you don't see a beam, decrease the magnification with the magnification dial on the right control panel. At low magnification, you see a bright spot. As you increase the magnification, you can see the copper grid. Use the joystick to move the sample. When you change the magnification, you also have to adjust the intensity to illuminate the whole field of view. Counterclockwise condenses the beam, and clockwise spreads the beam. Next, we will do alignment. Use the trackball to move the beam to the center, spread the beam, increase magnification, and then condense the beam. The rings are caused by diffraction. Click the U-centric focus button on the right control panel to reset the objective to the default value. Use the Z button on the right control panel and try to make the rings disappear. Increase the magnification to 125K. Again, use the trackball to center the beam, condense the beam, and use the Z buttons again to make the rings go away. Next, we must center the C2 aperture. Set the C3 aperture to position 3. Use the trackball to center the beam. Use the intensity control to condense the beam and then spread the beam. Notice that the beam expands off-center, indicating the C2 aperture should be adjusted. Rotate the C2 dials to center the beam. One dial moves it in the X and the other dial moves it in the Y direction. Again, condense the beam with the intensity button and open it to confirm that the beam remains on center. Next, we adjust the condenser stigmation. Click on Tune and Condenser from the Stigmator menu. Use the multifunction knobs, MF, on either side of the scope to adjust the condenser stigmation in both X and Y directions to ensure the beam is round and expands concentrically. After you are finished, be sure to click None, otherwise the multifunction will continue to control the stigmation. Now we do direct alignments. Select Tune, User Interface, Direct Alignments, and Beam Tilt PPX. Notice that there appears to be two beams. Adjust multifunction X and Y until the two beams merge to one. Click Done to save this setting. Repeat the beam tilt PPY and adjust the multifunction X and Y knobs until there is one beam image. Select Beam Shift and center the beam with the multifunction key, and then click Done. This saves the position of the beam so it can be recalled later if it gets lost. The trackball position cannot be saved. Select Rotation Center. The beam begins to wobble and the image moves. Adjust the multifunction dial until the movement of the image is minimized and the edge appears simply to go in and out of focus. Click Done to finish the direct alignments. Click Gun, FEG Registers. Type a name like TEM and save the alignment settings for future use.